taken up. So the Prophet ﷺ must have taught them something better in its place. Hence, whatever was adopted by the Sahaba from the Prophet ﷺ, that is what is to be followed. And hence the Prophet said, مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ وَأَصْحَابِي. Hence, we are Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Aqeedah of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, when it comes to a Sahabi, we keep our mouth shut. Because كُلُّهُمْ عَدُول. They are all trustworthy, they are all just, they are all honest. Yes, in the Sahaba, there were different categories in Fuqaha. There were different Sahaba who had different levels of understanding of deen. But when it comes to truthfulness, and being just, and being sincere, no one should ever doubt the sincerity and truthfulness and the goodness of any Sahabi. Sahaba are all كُلُّهُمْ عَدُول. They are all just. Hence the muhaddisun, they criticize, they make jirh. Jirh means criticism or ta'adil, endorsement of their positive aspects. But when it comes to Sahabi, the muhaddisun, even they dare not raise their pen or express an opinion with regards to a character of any of the Sahaba. Because Allah says in the Quran, radiyallahu anhum wa radu anhu. Allah chose, Allah is happy with them, they are happy with Allah. And like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, اختارهم الله لصحبة النبي والإقامة دينه. Allah chose them to be in the company of His beloved Prophet and establish His deen. So when the muhaddisun, when they make judgments or criticisms of narrators, there are many ahadiths in which when people classify a hadith, that they want to say, we want to say whether this is sahih or da'if or fabricated or hasan, they look at a particular chain and they say, this man in this chain is not reliable. So even if there's one person, because as they say in a chain, the strength of the chain depends upon the strength of the weakest link. Agar wo tootega to jahan se kamzor hai wahi se tootega na. Where if a chain is pulled, it will obviously break at the weakest point. So the strength of any chain is only proportional to the weakest link. So the strength of any sanad is only dependent upon the weakest link. If there's any weak link in there, they say this man is not trustworthy, so we will label this sanad as da'if. And when they do that, one man says this person is not reliable. The ulama have stated, in light of the teachings of the Quran, that to criticize someone, you can't criticize someone for nothing. You can't say he's not right. If you want to say he's not trustworthy, you have to prove your case why he's not trustworthy. You can't say that. You can't do that regarding a Muslim. Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ. Don't jump to conclusions about anything. Because usually conclusions can be wrong. But a Muslim can have a good opinion of another Muslim. Basically, every person is innocent until proven guilty. This is internationally accepted law. And so when it comes to narrations of hadiths as well, the muhaddisun have said, if a muhaddis makes criticism of any narrator, then he should prove his criticism. Why that person is not trustworthy. But to accept a narrator, or to accept any Muslim that he is telling the truth, every Muslim should have good expectation of another Muslim. Some people, they say, you should have good expectation of other Muslim in every aspect, except when it comes to him narrating something on behalf of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ke waise Musliman ko har Musliman ke bare acha gumaan hi karna chahiye ki ye theek hi hoga. یہ عام مسائل میں ہے لیکن جب حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی حدیث کے بارے میں آئے تو یہ قانون وہاں فٹ نہیں ہوتا تو وہ کہتے ہیں کہ ہر آدمی he should be known he should be proven to be reliable and trustworthy but other people say well this is an unnatural you know illogical expectation if you want to prove someone and you making accusation for him to be untrustworthy you should prove why he is not trustworthy Number one. Secondly, if there is a person that a particular muhaddith says he's not trustworthy and he has labeled him as da'if, there are many, many instances in which one muhaddith says this person is not trustworthy and other muhaddithun say he's trustworthy, he's totally reliable. And we often see such examples in society regularly, where one person might trust an individual with his life. Uske saath talqaat honge ya lain den hoga ya muamlaat hue honge, wo apni jaan ki baazi bhi uske liye laga sakta hai. He can trust him with his life. But another person might not even trust him with a penny. Yani koi dusra aadmi bhi hoga, us par usko koi aitbaar nahi aur koi aitmaad nahi. Similarly, there are many cases where one muhaddith considers one particular individual to be very authentic and reliable, and another muhaddith considers the same person to be unreliable. And hence, there are some hadiths as well, which by some muhaddithun are considered to be sahih, and the same hadith considered by another scholar to be da'if. And whether a hadith is sahih or da'if, or the sanad rather, is still a question of opinion. At the end of the day, whether a hadith is classified as sahih or da'if is not from Allah. Allah didn't say in the Quran this hadith is sahih. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say that this hadith will be passed on by sahih narration. Woh toh baad mein logon ne kaha na. Toh baad mein jo logon ne kaha, toh yeh unki apni raay hai. This is still their opinion. So whether a hadith is sahih or da'if at the end of the day is still opinion of people. It's not absolute. The absolute ones are only those which are mutawatir, because they have been passed on by so many different narrations. Hence, many ulama regard some hadiths to be sahih, while the same hadith is regarded by others to be da'if, and even many cases fabricated. There is a book which has been written on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seerah by a great alim from the Indian subcontinent. His name was Maulana Idris Kandilvi rahmahullah. It's entitled Seeratul Mustafa. In there he's written an incident whereby after Shaqqul Qamar, and this is a famous incident mentioned in the Quran as well, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went out and he split the moon, and this is known as Shaqqul Qamar. There was another incident in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam whereby he was returning from an expedition, and some people had not prayed their Asr Salat, and the sun had gone down and was almost set, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a dua and the sun came back up and the people were able to offer their prayer. Now Ibn Taymiyyah rahmahullah has rejected this incident totally and considered it to be absolutely fabricated and made up. There is another Shafi'i scholar and a grand scholar of his time. His name is Jalaluddin Suyuti rahimahullah. And some people have said that Jalaluddin Suyuti rahimahullah was such a great scholar that if there was any doubtful issue, and sometime he would have vision of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as many pious Muslims are blessed with the ziyarah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And while he would have a vision of the Prophet, he would inquire from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if a particular narration is right or wrong. He was a scholar of such caliber. And he's written a whole book on this issue, proving this incident to be not just authentic but mutawatir. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah says it's totally fabricated. Jalaluddin Suyuti rahimahullah says it's of the highest caliber. He's written a whole book on the issue, and to prove how this issue, the sun coming back, Radd al-Shams it's referred to, the returning of the sun, is not just authentic but mutawatir, undeniable, unquestionable. So I was saying, because whether a hadith is sahih or da'if or fabricated, at the end of the day, it's not an absolute issue from Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's still an issue of an opinion. It's opinion of scholars, because they form their opinion about different narrators and then they come to their conclusion. Hence, there are many hadiths which are considered to be sahih by some, and the same hadith is considered to be da'if by others, and in many cases even fabricated. And now what people, there is now recently a trend has developed that people just say da'if, da'if, da'if. Whatever doesn't suit their opinion, they say da'if. Why? Because somebody, and now, you know, to reject or accept or to classify a hadith to be sahih or da'if, it isn't the work of someone who's 1,000 years